region. So he'd be hearing about things that happened weeks upon weeks upon weeks earlier. Sometimes good news, somebody got married, sometimes bad news, somebody passed away. But it allowed him to remain connected to the people whom he left behind in a way that was deep and meaningful to him, and gave him something to look forward to each day. Now, we've had several votes in Congress since I was elected in 2009 to shut down, not Sunday delivery, lost that in the 50s, but Saturday delivery. And I think if the Republicans get away with it, they'd also shut down Monday, Tuesday, right. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday delivery, yep. And try to sell it all off to FedEx.
Yep. Right. Yep.
And the reason for that is very simple when you get down to it. Republicans are against the post office, by the way, the only profession mentioned in the Constitution.
Right.
The only occupation mentioned in the Constitution is the post office. They're trying to shut it down because the carriers are unionized. They're trying to shut down the public schools because teachers are unionized. They want to court battle to prevent the proverbial closed shop among teachers. And so to basically allow people to cherry pick and free ride on the backs of union members. I think that it's unfortunate that much of what we see in politics today is simply an attack on the right to organize. I don't know how meaningful that is to people here outside of our hosts, but I think it's worth noting. And it's worth noting in a particular context, which is this. Not only are the unions the sinews, the backbone of the Democratic Party, but they represent the spirit that we're all in this together. And that, I think, is the heart of what it means to be a Democrat, the sense that we're all in this together. That we're not just atoms bouncing off each other in the void. That we have a shared experience, as the Pope referred to it just a couple of days ago in Washington, D.C., called humanity. Humanity. And that shared experience answers a lot of questions about what kind of person you want to be, what kind of elected official I want to be, and it helps you, I think, to understand what it is that you do and why you do it. Why are we here today? Obviously, to support my campaign. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. But also to reflect our own shared values. It's an overused term, but I think that it applies here. Why are we Democrats? Why are we not Republicans? I tell people sometimes it's awfully difficult to be Republican. You know, you pretty much have to be white, straight, rich, Christian. It's hard. To be a Democrat, all you have to do is just simply be a human being. And understand what it means to be a human being. You know, I've been to literally every country in the world. I've been to every state in the United States, every country in the world. It took me a long time. And there are certain things that actually unite us as human beings. Everyone, everywhere around the world wants to fall in love. Isn't that interesting? Even in countries with arranged marriages, people still want to fall in love. Everywhere around the world, people cherish children. Not just their own children, but everybody else's children, too. Everywhere around the world, people want to be left alone. They want to live in peace. Peace is the most fundamental of all shared experiences, if you have it. Because if you don't have it, that's what you desperately want more than anything else. And everywhere, all around the world, people have a sense, like you all do, that we're all in this together. That we're human beings. And that's why I do what I do the way I do it. And that's why I'm proud to be a Democrat. Now, I have some good news for you all today. We're winning.
Yeah.
I want you to hear about this. I don't mean that I'm winning. I actually am winning. I've been ahead in the last four polls that I've taken the Senate race. So yes, I'm winning. But that's not what I meant at all. I meant we're winning. We're winning. Our values are winning. Yeah. Our priorities are winning. Our sense of what it means to be a human being, we're winning. And I'll give you a few examples. You know, I think that with the hubbub of everyday life, we sometimes need to take a step back. Put some of these things in perspective. I was the first Democrat elected to represent downtown Orlando in 34 years. My third vote in the House of Representatives was to extend health coverage to 4 million children. Sometime after that, I had the privilege of voting in favor of the Affordable Care Act. And now, as a result of that, I lost my job for 2 years. But 15 million people now have health coverage, didn't have it. And that is deeply important. You can't be wealthy unless you're healthy. And there's a fundamental human right to be able to see a doctor and respect him and get the care that you need to stay healthy and alive. Now, interestingly enough, that is not a shared value across the entire political spectrum in our country. It is in other countries. We're the only major country in the world without universal health care. We also have a life expectancy that's 2 years less than Canadians, 4 years less than Japanese. Maybe there's a connection there, since both the Canadians and the Japanese have universal health care. Certainly, I can vouch for the fact that our weather is no more difficult in Central Florida than it is in Yukon Territory. So that can't be it. It can't be the weather that makes them live 2 years longer. And in fact, if you ask Canadians what is it that stitches your country together, they will say universal health care, our national health care system. They'll say that. The Prime Minister, the Canadian leader who was named the Canadian of the Century, was the Canadian leader who instituted national health care in Canada. And it's a funny thing. I had $5.5 million spent against me in the 2010 election after I voted for the Affordable Care Act. $4 million of it was spent by the Koch brothers. And I had to pay a political price. I wandered in the wilderness for 2 years until I was reelected to Congress in the biggest comeback in the history of the U.S. House of Representatives. I only ever had a 43-point swing in 2 years before that was news, and that was new. But I knew that there would be people here in Central Florida, huge numbers of people here, 50,000 in my district alone already, who would be able to see a doctor when they were sick. And my sense was that was far more important than my own political future, good or bad, name or name. You know, it is a funny thing. When you're an elected official, you have to understand that those 10,000 children in my district who got health care, got to see a doctor when they were sick, they don't know who I am. They're children. They couldn't even vote for me. They're not old. Some of them, in some cases, I saved their lives. Or together, we collectively saved their lives. They don't know that. They don't know that they would have died, except for the fact that they got that health coverage. I can tell you for a fact that none of them has ever thanked me. But the fact remains that I know that I made that difference. And that's enough for me. I know, because you're here today, that's enough for you. The things that we fight for are things that actually demonstrate our concern for other human beings and our success politically. The 15 million people who have health coverage today didn't have it a short time ago. That represents our success. I'll give you another example. I go back to union examples because I happen to be the only member of Congress who's actually a union member. When I was elected to Congress, I called the American Federation of Government Employees, and I said, I'd like to rejoin. I'd actually been a member when I was 18 years old. And they said, well, you're a congressman. I said, yeah, that's right. And Barack Obama signs my paycheck the same way he signs your paycheck.